Having powerful weapons in Days Gone will be really important to survive, and you can actually already get some really good ones early in the game that will help you a lot against the Freakers and other enemies that you will encounter. So let's run down some amazing early weapons that you totally want to get in this video, including a really powerful weapon that you can get for defeating just a few hordes. I got some tips for that as well. A like on the video would of course be super appreciated, and let's go. Weapons in Days Gone have ranks, with 5 being the highest, and you can actually already get a taste of a rank 3 weapon in the first hour of the game, because you can borrow Boozer's shotgun, but you're not able to keep it though. So then you will be using your not so powerful rank 1 weapons. One of the early missions though for Copeland has you take out an ambush camp of human enemies. Like, this mission is totally not missable, but after you killed everyone in this camp, you will have to repair the generator, and then a lady will appear with an empty gun. You send her away, but when you do, she will drop her gun on the ground. And you can pick this one up, and you want to do that because it's a rank 2.22 repeater that will be better than the assault rifle on rank 1 that you likely got right now. The sad part about the weapons that you pick up though is that you cannot reveal the ammo at the gun locker. Here you can only do that for weapons that you bought, so the weapons that appear in this gun locker. Also, when you buy another weapon for your main hand slots, then you will drop this weapon on the ground, so be careful with that. What you can do though is buy ammo for this rifle at the merchants in the different camps, so totally do that when you are at the camp again to start using this rank 2 gun. I also came across some humanoid enemies that set up a trap right here on the map. I'm not sure if it's random, but you can of course check it out. One of them had a rank 2 sniper that you can of course also pick up if you want that for your special weapon slot. The merchant at Copeland's camp also sells ammo for the sniper rifle, so buy that and you are able to use it. Another tip would be to totally check the gun locker in your sort of home base where Boozer is, because there will already be a crossbow that you can pick up right after the tutorial to focus on some nice stealth kills. So this is all really, really early in the game, and the impact will be noticeable but not that drastic. The first drastic gun purchase will be a rank 3 assault rifle that will make your life way, way easier. You can get this one at the Hot Springs camp, so the second camp that you will visit, and you can actually already go here pretty early in the game. So where Copeland's camp is all about bike upgrades, thanks to Manny, in this second camp with the leader Tucker, you will find some of the best early, mid, and even slightly endgame weapons. The moment you arrive, you can buy the .22 repeater that we of course already picked up, but of course by buying it, you can refill your ammo at the gun locker and you will never be able to lose it again. But yeah, it's of course already nice that we could already pick it up and use it before reaching this camp. The weapon that you can buy when your trust is at level 2 though is the real game changer. The MWS assault rifle with pretty great damage, an insane rate of fire, but more importantly, 35 rounds in a magazine. So where the .22 repeater has to reload after 5 shots, you can fire 35 of those same shots with this gun. Okay, they do slightly less damage, but you will still be able to kill most enemies with just 2 shots. So yes, the goal should be to get to Trust Rank 2 with the Hot Springs camp. So I would suggest that you spend all your bounties here, so the ears that you collect from the Freakers. But there will also be a point where you can choose to give a drug stash to Tucker or Copeland. And yes, totally choose Tucker here to already get a nice head start and be able to get to Rank 2 of the Trust meter as soon as possible. Doing missions for Tucker will already help a lot as well, so make sure that you do all the missions that come available in this second Belknap region. But also different activities, including marauder camps or hordes in this region, will help you grow your trust. But you cannot really do the hordes yet, but when you get the MWS, then you can actually start hunting the smaller groups in this area or in the first area. Before we talk about the hordes and the amazing rank 4 offhand weapon that you can, by the way, already get by killing just a few of these hordes, now I first want to touch on two of the best weapons from the Hot Springs camp that you also want to get. The US-556 with almost a maximum fire rate and some great damage, just great for many situations, and the MG45 light machine gun that you can put in the special weapon slot and is nice against high health enemies or hordes. Both weapons will be really, really nice throughout the rest of the game, especially the US-556, so it will be worth chasing them as well. By the way, another tip is when you can finally buy these guns, to buy the magazine upgrade for these weapons as well in the supply section. Because that is the thing, when you buy specific weapons at a shop, they might have magazine upgrades at the supply section as well, but only at the same shop you bought these guns. And this will of course be super handy, because running out of ammo really sucks, and this will help you get the most out of that. But yeah, for these guns you need to reach rank 3 with the Hot Springs camp, and that can be challenging and will take some time. Just try and do missions for Tucker whenever they are available, and the many things you can do in the Belknap region, including the hordes. We'll have some locations for the hordes in a second, but first let's kill our first horde, shall we? Because an easier to kill horde is in the first region of the game that you will eventually get to with the Give Me a Couple of Days mission, where you have to pick up flowers for Boozer. It's over here on the map. The freaks will most likely be in the cargo train, but you can actually do a smart tactic to easily kill them one by one. And this of course after you got the MWS assault rifle, because that will be really really needed to take out the horde. So when you got that gun, then you want to go to this area, or again you'll eventually go here for the main story mission, and then get to the neuro checkpoint that is nearby. You want to push the car in front of this checkpoint to get to the top of the building. And then you want to make sure that you destroy the speakers on top of this neuro checkpoint, because there are namely speakers further away that will be active once you restore the power, and then make this whole horde, or at least a ton of the freakers, come to that point. And they can easily pick them off one by one. But of course first we want to get the fuel to be able to turn on the power again. You can find it near the car, so just grab it and then climb up again and then restore the power. Get of course the neuro injector. And then you will actually see that under the sort of cargo train there will be a ton of enemies like standing far away and also coming at you. So pick them off one by one. If you are out of ammo, don't worry, just buy new rounds at the gun locker inside the neuro checkpoints, and now just shoot a few of these enemies from afar, then they will come at you and you can just easily kill them with two shots. And just do this over and over again until all the enemies of the horde are gone, and then you will have your first horde. You'll need 4 in total though to get this amazing automatic sidearm that will be better than many of the other submachine guns that you can buy in the game. Like, it will take a really really long time before you can get a better one, so already having this relatively early in the game will be super super nice. What we want to do now is find 3 other hordes that you can easily take out. I killed them both in the third region of the game, the Lost Lake region, because there will be some nice smaller hordes there that you can easily take out, but I will also share locations of 2 hordes in Belknap that will also not be that hard to kill and can also help you increase the trust with Tucker to get the trust rank 3 guns. In Lost Lake, I found one over here on the map, left from the Lost Lake camp, and I really just reached this new area. It was dark and they were just running around, and that will be important as well, because the hordes sleep during day in these caves, but walk around during night. So when it's dark, you can go to this location, and then you will very likely stumble upon them. A smart tactic to take out a horde, and I will have more guides on this as well, is explosives. They are really really handy. I used the pipe bombs here that I think you can get from the Marauders, by the way. So what you want to do is drop a pipe bomb on the ground where you walk at that moment, and then just continue to run, maybe roll, because by the time the bomb explodes it will hit a ton of freakers and not you. And you will see that it was effective thanks to the insane amount of XP that you will get, and it already gives you an idea of how many of these enemies you killed. I used 3 of these bombs and then turned around, and there were only just a few of these swarmers left. So I killed them, and bomb, I cleared the horde. Another smart thing to do is use stamina cocktails, so you can keep running and rolling away so the horde will not be able to catch up. Again, more horde tips in a future video. The third horde I killed is actually nearby the second one. It's near the gas station in this area, also left from the Lost Lake camp. So I also found them during night. What you want to do is of course start shooting with your MWS and make use of the terrain as well, so the enemies have a hard time following you, something that will give you some time to turn around and shoot them. And I actually cleared this horde with just the turn around, focus shot and run tactic, no explosives, and bam, I killed my third horde. So now I need only one more to get this very powerful SPM 9 gun that is again way stronger than the other submachine guns that you can buy at the different camps. Also killing most enemies with just 2 shots. And of course, yes, it has a big magazine as well and is a submachine weapon that you can carry in a slot where you will normally have pistols or shotguns. So yes, it will be great to carry this weapon relatively early in the game, and the hordes that you have to kill for it are not that hard to take out. I said that I would share 2 locations for hordes in Belknap as well. You can find one over here. It was like dark as well, and this is likely their feeding ground. They were eating here, and they tend to ignore you as well or something. I could easily take them out one by one, but then I threw an explosive and they really started to come after me, but overall not a hard to kill horde. Another pretty easy one is over here in Belknap near the river. They were also slow to come after me here, so that gave me some time to take them out, and then bam, I think killing any of these hordes will be easy enough to get this amazing rank 4 submachine gun. And of course, like I already said, killing hordes in Belknap will increase the trust with Tucker's camp as well. Subscribe for way more Days Gone tips and tricks. I'm just getting started here, and we'll have way more videos coming your way. A like on the video would of course be super appreciated. You can watch my review of the game by clicking on the screen. And if other tips videos are already up, then you can see them on the screen as well. For now, I'll speak to you next time, and goodbye.